Unconsolidated jeepney drivers are allowed by the Philippine government to ply select routes for at least a month. Transport regulator LTFRB issued the memo Thursday ahead of the December 31 deadline for jeepney drivers to consolidate their franchises. It says individual operators will be allowed on public roads where less than 60% of jeepneys are consolidated. The LTFRB previously warned of revoking jeepney drivers' permit to operate if they fail to comply with the deadline. But the agency says unconsolidated drivers and operators will no longer be allowed to join existing consolidated transport groups. The LTFRB says it will announce more details on this soon.
Hindi natin alam kung anong klaseng pag-iisip nitong LTFRB ang ginagawa po nila. Isipin mo kung puro tricycle po ang pabibiyahin natin ng mas malayo doon sa original na ruta nila, mas mahal po talaga o doble hanggang triple po ang pamasahe po. Hindi po talaga nila mararamdaman yon. Nasa loob po sila ng opisina nila. Subukan po nila na mag-commute o yung mga taong nagko-commute po, yung kanilang tatanungin kung kumusta po ang kanilang biyahe. Pangbubuli po sa atin ng gobyerno, grabe po talaga. Sobra-sobrang pahirap po ito sa ating mamamayan, hindi lamang po sa aming mga sa ating mga drivers at operator.
Despite the reprieve, transport groups maintain phasing out traditional jeepneys could affect the country's economy.
Yung malaking porsyento na halimbawa mawawala sa hanin ng ating public transport ay malaking epekto nga yan, hindi lamang sa hanin ng mga driver at operator, kundi sa ating mga mamamayan, mismo sa ating ekonomiya. Dahil ang sinasabi nga natin, kapag nagkaroon po ng transport crisis sa ating bansa, ang direct effect niyan ay yung ating yung mismo yung ating ekonomiya. Kaya tayo ay yung sinasabi halimbawa ng mga taga LTFRB, taga DOTR, sinasabi nila papayagan namin yung mga tricycle, papayagan namin ng mga kung magbibigay kami ng mga special permit. Ito ay bahagi ng pagpapakita na talagang hindi konkreto, hindi malinaw yung programa sa balangkas ng modernization, kundi ang nagiging pagtugon lamang ay parang papachipat yung solusyon, hindi doon sa matagalang.
Senator Amy Marcos, meanwhile, is urging the Transportation Department to resume talks with groups for its jeepney modernization program. The president's sister also calls on the agency to address drivers' concerns and shun using deadlines as threats.
No temporary restraining order was issued to stop the implementation of the jeepney consolidation program after December 31st, 2023. Now, instead, respondents, the Department of Transportation and the Land Franchising and Regulatory Board were given 10 days to comment on the petition for certiorari filed by public utility jeepney operators and transport groups led by Piston.
And Battle TV Network SMNI moves to stop the suspension order against it. The Davao-based network filed a petition for certiorari prohibition and mandamus at the Court of Appeals Thursday. SMNI claims the National Telecommunications Commission, or NTC, violated the Constitution in ordering the suspension based on a House resolution. Now, this stems from a House panel investigation that found the network violated its franchise on three separate occasions, including failure of responsibility to the public when it allegedly peddled fake news. Corporate stories now. Metro Retail Stores Group continues its share buyback program. The Gaisano-led supermarket operator made a repurchase of 1,000 common shares on December 27. This is part of the 300 million shares buyback program, which was approved by its board of directors in January 2021. Meanwhile, Kitchen City and Figueroa Coffee Group strengthened their partnership. The two entities recently unveiled their lobby cafe at the World Trade Center in Pasay City. Kitchen City says the opening of that cafe is part of its long-term vision of offering good service and option for World Trade clients. FCG in turn reaffirmed its commitment to providing exceptional coffee experience to customers and supporting local communities. And finally, Shakey's Pizza announces a new chief operating officer starting next year. The pizza giant is promoting its general manager, Jorge Concepcion, to the COO position. He will be tasked to lead Shakey's day-to-day management of business operations. Concepcion will also help steer Shakey's leadership team to a strategic corporate direction.
Two U.S. senators seeking a recall of Tesla vehicles over supposed steering and suspension issues. Senators Richard Blumenthal and Edward Markey wrote to billionaire Elon Musk, urging him to swiftly recall Tesla cars that pose a safety risk. The letter cites a Reuters investigation that exposed how Tesla blamed drivers for frequent failures of components it has long known were defective. Tesla called that report wildly misleading, claiming the story is riddled with incomplete and incorrect information. General Motors sues the city of San Francisco over back taxes and penalties. In the lawsuit, GM is seeking $108 million in back taxes over the course of 7 years, alleging the company was charged a higher tax bill than warranted. It also seeking $13 million in penalties and interests. The Detroit automaker said its Cruise self-driving car unit is operated separately and should not be used to calculate GM's liabilities in the city. The lawsuit comes as San Francisco is projecting an $800 million budget deficit over the coming two fiscal years amid a pandemic recovery that has stalled.